Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to another video. This is Alex, MTV Alex, and as you can see, I'm on a different scenery because it's hot as F down there. So I come up to the apartment upstairs. You're gonna see a little more about that on the next video. Stay tuned for the next video. You don't wanna miss that next video. And the reason I'm over here again is because I have AC and it's a blessing. So what I have behind me is a short that I did a couple of weeks ago when I saw the mongoose Arlor. Yes, I said I wasn't gonna get it, but I did get it. And the reason behind it is because I got it actually for my son. It might still be a little bit too big for him, but he will grow into that in no time. So it was a smart move because of the components and everything. So let's go ahead and unwrap it, see what we got, set it up, and first impressions. Before I do that, I would like to go ahead and invite you to subscribe if you haven't done so already. If you want to support this channel, there's a link down in the description. Buy me a cup of coffee, and please turn the notifications bell on and share this video with somebody else who might be interested about the bike like this. Other than that, let's get this party started. Okay. So the box came in a few days ago and it's damaged over here at the front and at the rear. Almost passing through over here. So let's take this out of the box, make sure everything's all right. Again, I got this bike because I saw a post on Facebook about this bike, and that's when I did the short. And after that, I know Woofty got one already. He already published a video, which is great. I know his came in damaged. Hopefully this one is not. Let's see. Again, this looks like it's packed just like the Mongoose XR Pro. However, not as heavy. Not as heavy. This 2.6 tires. Oh my God. Look, my pedal box, how it came. I don't have a bike stand over here just yet, so I'm gonna go ahead and unwrap it and just set it up real quick. No big deal, done it this 1,000 times. So the Mongoose Arlor, this is a 27.5 mountain bike hardtail for Mongoose. And what's unique about this one is that Mongoose finally came on a big box bike with a taper head tube. And yes, this is a real taper head tube, much like the Swings. And to me, it's not a surprise because both of them are owned by Pacific Cycles, so they had to do something like that eventually, and they finally did. And the headset is most likely gonna be the 4456, just like the Swings, like the Swing aluminum comb, the Taft, the Boundary, and of course the Axum, and among some other ones like the Ascension. Same head tube. Same headset. If you want to put in a taper head tube, you can do so on that one. And let's talk about a little more about this thing. It comes with double wall wheels, a front and rear. However, we don't have a cassette in this one. We have a freewheel. And that usually takes me from not buying them, but this one is going to be for my son, and I don't expect to do many upgrades right away. And the good thing about this freewheel is that it's actually a 14 to 38 tooth cassette. So that's really in the pair with what the Axon comes with the 11 to 42. So it's really competitive and it's bound for upgrades later on. I can either change the hub itself it's a 32 hole hub. So I will have to either get a new wheel for the back with cassette compatible or change the hub. We'll see whenever the times comes, what I'm gonna do. Now, the other thing that I like about this one is the geometry on this one. Unlike the XR Pro, this is more shop bike compared, and we have different measures over here. Now, before I get into the measures, Kev Central already did a video with all of this, so I'm just gonna slightly talk about them. And then what I like about this bike, and I wish Swing would have done this, is that all the graphics, they're removable. Yes, you can take them off and customize it as you wish. And this is a big thing for me, because sometimes I don't want to advertise any brands, and this is a good way to customize this, personalize it, make it your own. So all of these graphics can come off. Now at the rear we have a Pro Rush derailleur with clutch. Yes, you can turn the clutch on and off. And at the front we have a 170 millimeter crank arms. They're taper squared with the 30 tooth chain ring. This is not replaceable, so whenever you need to upgrade, might want to go ahead and get a whole bottom bracket and crank set up for this one, which is part of what I'm gonna do. Now at the front we have an Element fork. It's a Element fork. It's 100 millimeter travel, but it has a lot of flex into it. So it's, I guess for $298 plus taxes, that's where they drawing back the money. Now on the handlebars, you have extra wide handlebars. However, they're steel. I think there's 650 millimeters, I believe, something like that. And yeah, they're steel, so they're pretty heavy, so bound to upgrade. And then we have the saddle. The saddle is kind of weird shape. I don't know if it's gonna be comfortable or not. We'll see about that. What I really liked about this bike, especially besides the geometry, is the fat tires. It comes with 2.6 compass, 30 dpi light, wire bead, 2x2s, and these are 2.6 tires, just like on the Axon. And they're really, I think they're gonna be like a combination where on trail, gravel, I think this is gonna be perfect as is, as a commuter bike, with bounce to make it a perfect bike. And that's what I like about this one. I like what it has right here on the, by the way, let's talk about angles. The seat tube angle is 74 degrees. And yes, the head tube angle is 66.5 degrees. That is perfect. And then lightweight, I weighed it and it was stock as is. It came at 35.56 pounds or 16.13 kilograms, 569 ounces. Now the seat tube, like I said, is 74 degrees. The diameter of the seat tube is 27.2 millimeters, and it comes internal dropper ready. It has the holes for the dropper post ready to go. And the fork offset, now talking again up the front, the offset is 51 millimeters offset. So this is a really competitive bike for $298. The only drawbacks that I see is that I don't have a cassette. But other than that, the matte burgundy color in this thing looks amazing. And I never had a 27.5. This is gonna be my first 27.5. Well, actually, it's gonna be eventually my son's. Hopefully, I get to upgrade it before he takes over that one. But I really like this bike. If you're looking for an affordable bike, I think this is at the pair right there with the aluminum comp or some of the Swing bikes out there. And they, like I said, they're owned by the same manufacturer, Pacific Cycle. So they had to come up and do something about these bikes as well. They couldn't stand behind because Mongoose being just like the Swings, they're being old brand for a long time. So I'm glad they decided to do something like this, up the game. And yeah, so if you're watching this video, you're probably looking into getting one of these. And again, I really recommend it. It's perfect for upgrades. I'm gonna take it to a trail, do a trail review. Let me go ahead and do my, this is a 17 inch frame, and I usually do large bikes. I have like, it's right there. So hopefully this bike does well. I'm pretty sure it will. And especially whenever I start doing some upgrades to it, especially when I start doing some upgrades to it, this is gonna be one of the best bikes that I'm gonna have. Well, kind of. I mean, we're comparing 27.5s. I have never had a 27.5. I went straight from 26 to 29, but this is an excellent bike. I can't wait to try this out. If you like this video, make sure you give the thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't done so. If you want to support this channel, there's a link for you down in the description. Buy me a cup of coffee if you're interested in doing so. And other than that, that is it for this one. Stay tuned for the next video. I'm going to be talking about my Mongoose XR Pro in the next video. And other than that, that's it for this one, guys. Stay tuned for the review, the trail review on this one. And I'll see you on the trails. Bye.